Hi everyone, this is Anjil Pathak and welcome to my channel. Today in this video, we will learn how to automate your KPIs. Now KPIs, as I showed you in the last video, are basically the metrics which your business users are interested to know, like how the business is performing. So KPIs help in gauging that thing basically. So if you see here, we have sales, profit, profit ratio, quantity, right? So we know basically, okay, so this much amount of sales we have done, this much amount of profit we have gained, right? What's the profit ratio and how much quantity is being sold? So these are the KPIs. Now, normally you can drag your KPIs and then change every month manually and then republish the dashboard. But that is quite cumbersome, right? So basically you have the option to automate these KPIs so that you don't have to go every time and change the month and then again republish the dashboard. So that's one thing. And another is to add certain context to these KPIs. Like if you see here, we have last year value as well, right? So we know, okay, this sales is our current sales, and when compared to last year, it's like up by 26.6%, right? And further to this, we have sparkle lines displaying, you know, this is the YTD, okay, so current year performance versus the whole of the prior year, okay? So this way, you have added a lot of information here in a single KPI, and which gives really good, meaningful information to the business users. Now they would know, okay, my profit has jumped up as compared to the last year, right? And it's really performing well as compared to previous year. So this way you can, it gives a quick glance basically how the trend has been of that particular KPI this year versus prior year. And also in percentage terms, it gives you like what was the change, right? Experience this month versus the last year same month, okay? So let's go to Tableau and let's see how can we automate these KPIs and add certain context to KPIs. Okay. So I'll be using the Global Superstore dataset. I'll leave the link to download this dataset in the description of the video. So number one point, basically whenever you are automating your KPIs, we need to know what is the maximum data available in your dataset. So here we are concerned about the order date. Okay, so everything, every other metric revolves around the order date. So what we'll do is we'll create a field called as max date. Okay, and this will be nothing but an LOD, and which just simply calculates the maximum order date. Okay, so this is a table scoped LOD, because I have not used any fixed or you know, any other keyword basically here, and I have used only the curly braces here, and this gives me directly the maximum order date which is present in the data set. Okay, and if you want to know further on the level of details, you can watch my video. I'll leave the link of that video also in the description. Okay, so this will give me the maximum date available in my data set. Okay, once this is done, then what we need to do is find out the last day of last full month. Okay, now what do I mean by that is, let's say you have got the data. Let me open the Global Superstore data set and I'll show you basically what I'm telling you. Okay, so let's say we have an order date and it's available till, okay, September. So let me select September. And if you see here September, I think last date which is available is 20th. Okay, so we don't have data for the entire month of September, right? So our KPIs should contain only the data of the last full month. So if you consider this data, our last full month will be August, because if you go here and select August over here, August, and come here, let's go down, and you see data is available till 31st of August, right? So that's why we need last day of last full month. Okay. So last day of last full month in our case will be 31st August, right? So let's create that calculated field. Okay. It will be called as last day of last full month. Okay. Just now I showed you that full month, which is available in our data set, is August and not September. So we want to get the last day of that August month, which is 31st of August. So we simply have to create one calculation, which will be like date trunk. Okay. Now, if you want to see what date trunk does, you can click on this arrow and see. Okay. So it basically truncates the specified date to the accuracy specified the date part. Now, whichever date part you specify here, like here in example, they have a specified quarter. So when you give the date, okay, so near the last, the quarter of that date, basically, if you see here, this is August, 15th August, right? So quarter starts from July. So it will truncate it to 1st of July, right? So this way, what we'll do here is, we'll date trunk use, and date part will be month in our case, okay? Month, and then we'll use the max date, plus 1 and then minus 1. Now let me explain what it does basically. So this portion I'll just copy and explain you. Okay. Yeah. So this part, okay. If you see here max date plus 1, right? So what this is doing is whichever available date in your data set, okay, the max date pulls out that date, right? So in our case, that is 20th September, the max date. When you will add plus 1 to it, it will give you 21st September, right? Okay, so this will give you 21st September. Then it is basically date truncating that date. Okay, now let me copy that. Okay, so this will give me date trunk month, right? So month, it will take me to the first of that month. So it will give me 1st of September, right, 2021. Okay, why? So are you getting this? This is max date plus 1. So max date in our data set is 20th September. When you add 1 to it, it will give you 21st September. Then if you truncate at month level, this date is 21st September. So when you truncate it to month level, it will give you 1st of September 2021. And then the last step, you see here minus 1. So it will basically subtract 1 day from this, which will give you 31st August 2021, right? So that is, if you debug this formula, this is what we are getting, 31st August 2021. Okay, so let's go to Tableau again and press OK. If you want and convert this to date, we don't want it date time. And whenever you want to see what is the output, you can always drag this and click on exact date and then click on discrete. Okay, discrete over here. And if you see, the output is 31st August 2021. So this way you can quickly verify whether your calculation is working fine or not. Now, second step would be to create the first day of that last full month. Okay, so we will write here first day of last full month. Okay, again we will use date trunk. So this time we already have the last day of full month, which is 31st of August. We just need to date trunk that month, right? So just use the month part and use that field. Okay, last day of last full month. Now, if you again want to understand this function, I'll just copy this and tell you. So this last day of full month is already, we know, 31st of August, right? So this, if you copy here, this is nothing but 31st August 2021. And when you date trunk this by month, so we are truncating it at month level, this value. So when you truncate it at month level, basically it takes you to the first of that month. So basically it will take me to 1st of August 2021. Okay. So here we will get the answer as 1st of August. Now again convert this to date and just pull it here, and again just go here and click on exact date, then click on discrete. So again you see here 1st of August 2021. Okay, so these two are done. Now what we have to do, this is like, you know, this we have created a bucket basically, first day and last day. We want to get data around these two dates, right? So that we have the data of one full month. Okay, so what we will create is new field called as most recent month. Okay, so just you have to, you know, create a binary calculation over here, and we will check with our order date. Okay, it should be greater than or equal to first day of last full month, and okay, because we want both conditions to be true, so we'll use as and then this should be less than equal to last day of full month. So it's like a Boolean condition. It will check if order date is greater than or equal to first day of last full month and order date is less than equal to last day of last full month, which in our case this is 1st of August and this is 31st of August. So it will give me data from 1st of August 2021 to 31st of August 2021. Okay, just click OK here. And you see here, this is a binary field. It will reflect only true and false. Now, if you see here, we also want the last year percentage to be calculated. So for that, first we will have to get the last year values. Okay. So let me build calculations for that also. So just create a new field. Now this will be called as last day, day of last full month last year. Okay, this is because we are calculating for last year. Okay, so simply what we'll do is date add, and then what we can do is we just have to shift 1 year. Okay, so just shift 1 year, which will be minus one, and the date will be last day of last full month. Okay, so again I'll explain you here what is happening. Now if you see here, last day of last full month, we already have that, right? What is that? This gives us 31st August 2021. When you say date add year minus one to this, okay, it will simply subtract 1 year from this date, so it will give me 31st August 2020. It is subtracting 1 year from this date, so it is giving me 31st August 2020. Okay, so that's how we got the last day of last full month last year. Just press OK. Again convert this to date. You can quickly check this. Okay, exact date. Again click on discrete and you see 31st of August 2020. Now we will same way, we'll create the first day of last full month last year. Okay, now this time what we'll do is we'll simply date trunc the month part, right, of the previous calculation, which we have last day of full month last year. Okay, so again if you want to understand this, I'll just quickly walk you through. So this last day of last full month last year we have just calculated here. If you see, this will give you 31st August 2020, and now we are saying to truncate this date to month level. So when you say date trunc month on this date, what it will do is it will truncate it to first of that month, so 1st August 2020. Okay, so just click OK over here. Again convert it to date. We don't want date time, and drag this here again select exact date, again select discrete. Now you see 1st of August 2020. Now again we will create a boolean condition. Now this time it will be called as, let's say, most recent month last year, okay? And again it will be a simple boolean check, order date, it should be greater than equal to first day of last full month last year. Again AND condition we want, and order date should be less than equal to last day of last full month last year. So this way it will give me data around the same time last year, right? Same month last year. So just click OK. Again it will create a boolean condition over here. So now we have the KPI sales, quantity, profit. We'll just create the KPI called as profit ratio. It will be sum of profit divided by sum of sales. So this is nothing but profit ratio. Now we want to automate these, right? So what we'll do is we'll create a sales last month, right? So this will be sales. You can use this nomenclature, you know, you just insert a pipe over here and then write the next thing. So sales last month, okay, is nothing but you have to sum, okay, sum. When you have to sum, if your most recent month, if most recent month, then you have to simply sum the sales and then AND. Done. So basically this is a boolean field, right? Most recent month here, if you see, this is boolean. So whenever that's true, it will just sum up all the sales for that. So this will be true only for the last month, so it will bring me sales only for the last month, okay? So that's why we call it as sales last month, and click OK. Then same way we'll create sales last year, last month last year, okay? Again we will sum, okay, if most recent month last year, this time we'll use most recent month last year, then sales AND, okay? So same way, this time whenever this is true, it will bring in sales, and this will be true only for last year August month, right? In our case, so it will bring me last year August sales by this calculation, okay? Now what we'll do is last month is done, last month last year is also done. Now we will calculate the delta. So this will be called as sales pi button, then delta, and then this delta is nothing but the sales last month minus sales last year last month, right? So just click OK here. This is delta, and then we will calculate the change. So this will be sales delta percentage, and now we will call it as sales what will be the sales delta, right? So sales delta we have to divide by sales last year, right? Last month last year. So we are seeing the change over the last year sales, what percentage will it give? So that's why delta percentage, okay? And now we need to create the arrows. So if you see here, we have up arrows and we can also have down arrows. So we need to create two calculations for those. So let me build that also. So for sales, let's say delta arrow up, okay? So this will be nothing but your if sales delta, okay? If sales delta is greater than zero, then we have to pull that arrow and AND. So for pulling that arrow, you can use the alt code Okay, so I'll just copy this here. Okay, and paste it here. Okay, so this is my arrow up for sales delta. Similarly, I'll have one for down. So sales delta arrow down. Right. Again, this will be if sales delta, if that is less than zero, then I'll put here arrow and then end. So again, I'll go here and copy the down arrow. Okay. And paste it here. So this is down arrow. Okay. So this is one. Now, this is all these calculations we have done for one particular KPI, which is sales. Similarly, we'll have to do it for profit, for quantity, and for profit ratio. Okay, so just to save the time, I have created all those calculations, which is basically similar to the sales one, which we created here. Similarly, we created for quantity, for profit ratio, and for profit. Now, what we have to do is basically put all these KPIs in one sheet. Okay, so just click here and let's say minimum of 0.0. This will create one axis. Now we want four KPIs. So just control and drag. Okay, control and drag. So we have got four here. Okay, and edit these axes over here. And it should be from minus 1 to 0.1. Okay. For all the axes. This is just to, you know, do the alignment. Minus 1 to 0.1. Edit axis. Again, minus 1 to 0.1. And last again minus 1 to 0.1. Okay, so once we are done with this, we can hide this axis. Okay, and we have here four marks cards, if you see here, right? One we have for all, and the remaining 1, 2, 3, 4, each corresponding to these fields. First one corresponds to this 0.0. Then this one 0.0 corresponds to this second one. This third one corresponds to this third pill. Fourth one corresponds to this fourth pill. Okay. So on first one, we will drop basically sales last month. Okay. So we'll start seeing the sales which happened last month. And we also want to see the delta percentage, right? So we'll drag this one. Okay. And we'll also do this to fit height. Okay, currently we'll do fit height. Let's see, we'll do it later on the adjustments. So it's like 26.6%. If you don't get this in percentage, you can always go here and change the default properties. You can select the percentage from here. Okay, so that will be taken care of then. And we also have to basically throw arrow up over here and arrow down over here. Okay, and now at least we have something over here. I'll show you again how to do the formatting part. Okay, and similarly on the second one, what we can do is we'll pull the profit last month, then we'll pull the profit delta percentage, then arrow up, then arrow down. Okay, so this is done. Then we'll do it for profit ratio. So again, profit ratio last month, profit ratio delta. Okay, so we don't have delta percentage for profit ratio because it's already a percentage field, profit ratio, right? So just if you subtract last year last month from last month, it will give you the percentage only. So that's why we don't have delta percentage. and now we'll pull arrow down, arrow up. Okay, so this is also done, and then we'll go here. Last one is the quantity, so quantity last month, and then quantity delta percentage, arrow down, arrow up, right? Okay, so this is all done. Then just quickly go to, you know, format, borders. We don't want any lines over here, just click none wherever you see lines. Okay, no column dividers. Okay, then go to this grid lines. We don't want any grid lines, no zero lines, no trend lines, no reference line, no axis rulers, no axis sticks, and no drop lines, right? So this is all done. Yeah, so this one we'll have to use a transparent shape. So from here, what you can do is you can always select the mark as shape. Okay, and once you select the mark as shape, it will give you this circle. Okay, if you see here, we want to hide that circle, so you can always use a transparent image, which I have already kept in my my Tableau repository. So if I go into the my Tableau repository, I have a folder called shapes, and I've created one folder called as KPI, and I've placed a transparent image over here. Okay, so I'll be utilizing this image. Okay, and I'll go here in shape, and I'll select that folder called KPI, and here I have this transparent image. I'll just click on this and click OK. So you see that those shapes have gone now, because they have been replaced by transparent image. Okay, now we will edit these visualizations. Okay, so come here and go to label. This one belongs to first one, which is the sales. After coming here, click on the text. Okay, just click on text and it will show you what is getting displayed. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll just put an enter and we'll take everything to the left side. Okay, and then just click as just write sales. So this is sales, and then what I want is sales value last month, right? So I'll take this, I'll copy this here, and this should be like bold, right? This should be the 20 point bold and Tableau semi bold, I think semi bold, yeah. Okay, and then this should be 10 point Tableau regular. Okay, let's select 10 point. Then you write here last year. Okay, I want to display it as last year. And then arrow should come, right? So whether it's arrow up or it's arrow down, okay, only one of them will come depending on the value of the delta. If the delta value is less than zero, then arrow down will be displayed. If the delta value is more than zero, then arrow up will be displayed. But only one arrow can be displayed. That's how we have defined the calculation. Okay, and then the delta percentage value. So what you can do is you can select this delta arrow up, okay, make it bold and select this as green color. Okay, and similarly for arrow down, we will select bold and then red color. Okay, and the last value you can also make it bold. Okay, just click OK here, and if you see here, nicely done KPI, we see it on our dashboard. So this is sales, right? And similarly we'll do it for profit, profit ratio and quantity sold. And if you see here, we hover so many, you know, in the tooltip we see so many of cluttered data, right? So always is good if you come here, from all button you can switch off this, because we want to turn off tooltip for all of these. So just come to all and click on this. We don't want to show tooltips. you don't want to include command buttons, you don't want to allow section by category, just click OK and these are gone. Okay, so in the interest of time, I have gone ahead and just formatted these all KPIs as well. So almost half of the job is done. So we have automated all these KPIs. Now every month these KPIs, you know, will always reflect the last full month data and the comparison with the last year same month. Okay, so right now it's displaying August month data, right? August 21, and comparing it with August 2020 data. So same way, once September month data is available completely, this value will change to September month data and it will compare to September 2020 data. Okay, so this way we have automated the KPIs. Now we just want to insert the sparklines, which will show the YTD trend as well as the last year trend. Okay, so just let me go back. So for displaying these sparklines, I'll have to make two calculations basically. So for creating these sparklines, see, we have to show YTD data, right, as well as last year data, right? So last year full data, right? Full last year data. Okay, so for YTD, what we can do is we can fix the last point, right? Fix the last basically end date, right? End date, that your data should be less than the end date. And for last year, we just have to fix the, you know, fix the start date, which will be the basically last year 1st January, right? So it will be 1st January 2020. Okay, full last year, so it should start from 1st Jan and it should continue till the end date of the year, this year, which is like in our case 31st of August 2021. Okay, so for that I'll create two calculations over here. Okay, one will be full month. Okay, so let's say I want to have full month. Okay, so basically my order date should be, you know, less than equal to last day of full month. This is already calculated. This is nothing but which gives you 31st of August. Why we are calculating less than? So that, you know, my September month data should not be included, because I don't want to include any half calculated data, and September month is not available in entirety, right? So we have only August month data, which is available up to full data. So that's why we are calculating less than equal to. So just click on OK. This will be done. And then another calculation, which will give me start of the last year. Okay, so last 2 years data we will say, and we will basically use date trunk. Okay, so I want to date trunk the month part of order date, and that should be basically greater than or equal to, okay, so my order date should be greater than or equal to 1st January 2020. Now how will I get that? Basically you have to do date add, the part will be year, we'll do -1. Okay, we'll go to 2020 from 2021. Okay, and then we'll do date trunk. Okay, again we will be using the year date part, and we'll use the max date, right? So what is happening here is, when you use max date, in our case it was somewhere in September, right? So whatever date you get in the maximum in the data set, it will date trunk to year level. So for 2021, this will give you 1st of January 2021. So what we are doing is subtracting -1 year from that. So this will take you to 1st January 2020. Okay. So what we are saying is, your order date should be greater than or equal to 1st January 2020. And your order date should be greater than or equal to that value, right? So just click OK. So this is last 2 years and this is full months. We'll have to use in combination these two filters. Okay. And now let's build the sparkle lines. So we'll pull sum of sales over here. Okay, sales over here, and order date. Okay, month of order date over here. Okay, this one month of order date. Okay, and also pull year of order date over here in colors. Okay, so we'll have one line for each of the years. And now to restrict this data to only last year and this year, we'll have to use these two filters which we have just created. So last 2 years, okay, just click here and drag this and click on true. Okay, so now this has the data for previous year and this year entirely, but we don't want September data, right? We want only full month data. So you will have to drag this also. And the moment you click on true, you will see that this September data here, this will go away. This line will go away because the complete data is available only till August. Okay, so this blue line, just notice this blue line, it will be available only till this August. Okay, the moment I press okay, right? Because September data is not completely available, so that's why we have excluded it. Okay, and then you can always, you know, go in colors and play with these colors. Okay, I like to keep it light gray for the last year and then blue color in YTD, and then go to edit axis, and from edit axis you can deselect this include zero. Okay, so that and you get good amount of space for the visualization to be displayed. And then you can just click on show header over here. You don't want show header over here, and then hide all these lines. So again, you can go to format, borders, just select none for all these. Okay, and same way for grid lines, none, trend lines, none. Yeah, so this is now a neat chart. You can hide the title also. This is a sparkle line chart. Okay, now we will fit these charts. Basically this one is for sales. Okay, this one if you sales. Similarly, I have prepared for others. Like if you see, this one is profit, then we have for profit ratio, then we have for quantity. Okay, so like this, I have prepared for all of these. Now what we'll do is we'll create the dashboard over here, and we will first drop a vertical container, and let's pull the first KPI sheet. Okay, we don't want sheet name, by title, then pull another horizontal container over here. Okay, and reduce this a bit, and you can also set the size. Okay, let's increase the width and height a bit. Okay, and then let's bring one more horizontal container here. Okay, so we have this horizontal container over here. And then in this horizontal container, let's drag one by one the sparkle lines. Okay, so just drag it here and we can cross this. We don't need it. Okay, and we also don't need any title. Similarly, we can pull in profit. We don't want any distinct legends or titles. Pull profit ratio over here. Again, this is coming up. You just need to get rid of this. Then pull quantity. Okay, again, we don't want this. Hide this. Okay, now to shorten this, what you can do is you can pull in what you can do is just select this and go to select container horizontal, and we will edit the height. Okay, so we don't want the height to be more than, let's say, 75. Okay, so this gives me, okay, and then you can just fix height. Yeah, so I have fixed the height of these sparkle lines, And similarly here also you can again insert a horizontal container here. So let me insert it here, and then I'll drag this inside this horizontal container. Okay, and then pull this up. Okay, and I will select this. Okay, and edit height, maybe somewhere 110. Okay, fix height. Okay, this again has gone down. I don't know why, but let me edit the height 75. Okay, and then we can show dashboard title. This will be like, let's say KPI metrics. Okay, monthly maybe. Okay, and you can select this and then do semi bold, this maybe 36, blue color middle. Okay, something like this. Okay, now your client would be more than happy to see such a KPI dashboard, right? Because he is able to see all the numbers on a monthly basis. This is my sales, how is it performing versus last year same month, how is it doing this year, how did it do last year, and all the four metrics I am able to see in one single chart, right? And it is giving me a good context, right? These numbers are not in isolation, so it helps your business user basically understand the current situation of the business and take proper decisions based on these information in the data, right? So I hope you like this video, enjoyed this video. Do like this video and subscribe to my channel, and thank you.